Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Slaughter Havoc here, and so here's the deal. I have been like kind of putting off making an episode because I want to get stuff set up to continue with the Draconic evolution, right? And so it was funny. I was in the process of just like thinking to myself, "Hey, I've got another great idea in the meantime," and I was just getting ready to record, like literally just about to hit the record button. When I got the thing I've been waiting for probably about 2 days now of just constantly grinding out, I went ahead and made all the Wavern armor and the Wavern sword. And the reason I did that was, well, first of all, because the armor's pretty sick. Like, look how fast I am. That's just nuts, right? And then on top of that, the sword is like freaking 20 attack damage. And this is, oh, plus 36 attack damage because I now have sharpness 4 on it. And Soulbound prevents items from being lost on death. Interesting. Oh, and knockback too. That was one hell of an enchantment. I literally just did this a second ago. All right, because you can see I've got Reaper 4 right here. And I've been holding on to this to find a second one. So I can make Reaper 5, and I'll explain what all that's about in just a second. But the whole point of it all was, as I was sitting there, I've been playing with animals over here and killing a lot of animals. So if you can kind of put the Reaper concept and the animals together, you might see where I'm going with this. I've been trying to get souls from the animals because I want to reincarnate. I forget the actual term, but basically bring back the Ender Dragon so I can try to get another heart. Because I used my first one, and I'll explain that, you know, later on, possibly in this episode, I don't know. But I was like, you know, all these animals over here, I want to make an animal farm, like a farm for fluids and stuff like that. And you can see this dude over here, he's just in total isolation. I almost feel bad. Like, this dude is straight up isolation right here. I have got him completely blocked off. But I was like, you know, this is working, and it's a Bedrockian one, and that's the reason for it is, and this is what gave me the whole idea. Like, right, I forgot I had this Bedrockium guy over here. I just hooked him up not too long ago. But he's constantly giving me Molten Bedrockium, which then I now have another Ender Tank connected to my Smell Tree over here. And that's all I have in there. And now I can make blocks of Bedrockium, and then I've just got tons of Bedrockium now, which means I can make Bedrockium Tanks. I think that's what they're called. And then they just store so much fluid. So, you know, in the concept of modded and going excess, that's where we're headed with this, basically. Is I now have this Bedrockium ingot, which gives me slowness 4. That's freaking awesome. And I want to break it down because I want to go... Yeah, I can still go fast. I want to try to make one of these guys. I know I have to make the golden plates. So much wasted material there. There we go. So I need two of these to make a Bedrockium tank. And then I think I need a cauldron. So let me just get some iron real quick. And as you can see, I'm up to 11,000 iron. And what's really funny about that is I have yet to even incorporate my quarry in the Deep Dark into the system. I still do it manually, and I really need to stop doing that. But anyways, we are going to make our first Bedrockium plate or tank. Of course I can't press T, so where is the weighted plate? There it is. And some Bedrockium. Oh, I have been working my hiney off to get Bedrockium. Let me tell you. I've been trying to do it every which way. I've paid for it using 9 diamonds with some triple and quadruple compressed cobblestone. It was all set up over here. I literally just tore this stuff down. I have tried to make an episode like 5 different times now. And when we get to the end, I'll kind of show you what was all going on. But for right now, this is what we're going to do. I need to grab a servo because I'm taking all of this Bedrockium out of here now. And we are going to go relocate and start a farm, basically. Yeah, so we're going to start a farm. There we go. Take it all out of there. Drain this thing. I have drained this thing empty. There's nothing in it anymore. I don't even use the smelter anymore, if I'm going to be honest. It's kind of useless to me. Because I get so many ingots from everything else. The smelter really doesn't serve much of a purpose unless I want to like, you know, make some upgrades or stuff like that for weapons and whatnot. So anyways, this is going to seem kind of crazy, but, well, hold on, let me see something first. I don't know if I can just set this down, if that will put into it. Do you have any? You currently don't have any. How many ticks are away? You're getting close. I kind of want to wait and see if it'll just pump right into this drum. Because if it pumps right into the drum, as you can see, it holds 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it holds 65,536 buckets of whatever fluid, liquid, whatever. You're almost there? Oh, no. You're like a long ways away. All right, we'll come back and test that. If not, I will just put one tank on top of this and one tank right next to it. And we'll have two ender tanks per. But what I want to start doing is setting up a little, basically a farm for, like, you know, resident ender, manilium, all that. So we're going to go make a whole bunch of these ranchers real quick. I'm going to need, because these are all separate metals that I might like to use. Alamite, probably not, because I've already got the manilium. You know what, let me just get him out of the way real quick. Let me get rid of the cows that I don't want. Invar, yes, I use a lot of Invar. But Alamite, no. And that's biofuel, possibly. Molten glass, potentially. Ender, for sure. Plutonium, I don't know if I'll ever need it. Electrum, yeah, I use it. And steel's good. Okay, cool. So I've got 2, 4, 6, 8. I have 8 cows, so I need to go make 8 ranchers. And we're going to set up a little freaking moo fluid farm. And eventually I'll figure out a way to properly put them into the ME system. I'm not 100% sure how to do that yet, but I'm sure I'll be able to figure it out. I've done a lot of figuring out lately, so. Let's see, a rancher. How do we make a rancher? A rancher is, are those regular shears? Okay, cool. So I need 8 of these. So I'm going to need 16 shears. So we'll start with that. 1, 2, 3. I hate tools. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. Cool. Now I'm going to need 16 of these guys. So let me just do a whole stack. There we go. Cool. I've got plenty of those materials. So, and then the machine frame actually is going to need those. Ooh, I need some glass. I think I rearranged my glass around here. Oh no, the glass is down in this guy, right? Pulverizer, redstone furnace. Nothing's making glass right now. I can't use crystal clear glass. Quite clear glass or whatever it's called. What glass do I have? I can craft. Let's try crafting. I need 8, so it's going to be 8 times 4 is 36, 32, wow. Okay, missing 30, well, yeah, no. Does that really say I'm missing 32 glass as I'm trying to make 32 glass? Where, okay, I know, I think I moved it somewhere when I was doing something, so it's in a slot that it can't. Yeah, because I need to add more furnaces. I'm going to be expanding pretty soon into the last millennium and start making like a whole bunch of redstone furnaces, a whole bunch of alloy smelters, just to make the system as like efficient as possible. But I haven't done that yet. So with that being said, where's my alloy smelter? Can I use quite clear glass? Let me try making some quite clear. Which one are you? Quite clear glass. Let's make, I think it makes 3 at a time. So let's make 3 real quick and see if that works. Oh, shoot. I need 4. Oh, not thinking. I mean, it makes 3 at a time, but whatever. Let's make 1 and see if quite clear works. If not, it's okay. Oh, it does work. Cool. Okay. So I'm going to need 7 more of those, which means 7 times 4 is 714, 21, 28. All right, so you'll make up 28 of those real quick. And what else do I need for the rancher? I'm gonna need plastic, I'm assuming, yep. So I got all those, I need 8 of these guys. Let's make 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There we go. And got you... Ooh, plastic pipe. Cool. I need 8. That's perfect. And then... Ooh, I need plastic, but I think I made a recipe for that now. Yes, I did. So there's 6. I need 16 totals. I need 10 more. Let's go ahead and make those up real quick. All right. And while that's cooking, now I can make the machine frame. Nope, that's a machine frame. Well, no, that's a machine frame too. Just do this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There we go. Got all of you. And finally, plastic. You're just about there. There's 18 of them, which I think is enough. Rancher. Like so. And there we go. There's 8 of them. Cool. We've got them. And then I'm going to need some conduit. I want to start stepping up to the next level of conduit. This Ender Energy Conduit, just because it lets a lot more RF through. But at the same time, I feel like, I guess it's not really necessary right now. I'm not doing anything that's really, you know, draining power or anything like that. So we'll go ahead and start you up. So I think I might just stick with this right now. But I do want to get to high end for everything. Like, I want to get rid of these fluid conduits and get these pressurized fluid conduits. Which are relatively cheap. It's just fused quartz glass with this conduit binder versus regular glass with the conduit binder. So right, it seems relatively easy and worthwhile, right? Let me see. Okay, there's 8. Didn't I order like 20? I ordered like 20, didn't I? Did I run out of something? Oh, it's just cooking up the conductive iron right now. Okay, there it goes. Pump it out of that machine right there. Right? Yep. I'm making the last one right now. There it goes. All right. These systems are working good, but they could be working better. And that is my constant process, is trying to improve on all this stuff. So let us go. You know what? I'm going to make some more ender tanks too. At the worst, I'm going to need 16. So I don't know how many I can make. How many can I make? One. Of course, I can make one. What was that middle item there? Oh, cauldron. Cool, I can make that. So I need 15 of these. And this is going to be an objective that I haven't done yet, so that'll be fun. I need more blaze rods. Okay. We can take a trip with Nether and get some blaze rods. Or is there a recipe for blaze rods? Can I make blaze rods somehow with blaze essence, which I don't have. I don't have any blaze essence planted. And then in epic loot bags, it looks like. Cool. Let's take a trip to the Nether. I'm going to go ahead and throw on my fire resistance here. One of these is fire resistance. Brew of, that guy right there. No, that's brew of, oh, magma skin. Yep, that's the guy. And we're going to go ahead and throw him on. Like so. I don't know if the magnet still works when it's... Nope, it definitely works when it's just in my hand. Okay, cool. And this guy will slaughter mobs like no other. So we should be able to fly through and get quite a few right off the bat, because we want to get this farm set up. I'm trying to follow the objectives in the book, and I'll show you by the end of this episode. I'm hoping not to go too much longer. By the... Oh, man. I had you set for the end. Let me go ahead and grab my multimeter and change you over to the Nether. Like so. Apple is the Nether now, just in case you didn't know. I had my Nether just literally disappear. I don't know what happened. It just disappeared. But, or I shouldn't say it disappeared. It did something really weird. I warped to it, but then my plate wasn't there. This plate wasn't here. The tesseract that's under it wasn't there, but oh, and this dirt wasn't here, but the Nether fortress was, and then my portal, actually I can show you now, my portal's not here anymore either. So I was kind of trapped here for a minute trying to figure out what was going on, and I forget how I ended up doing it. Oh, I had obsidian on me. I had obsidian on me. And so basically, I had to have blazes shoot at me until they lit the obsidian. It was funny. It was really funny. But all we're going for is blazes right now. I'm really not in the need for withers anymore. There's a blaze rod. Yep. If you notice, I'm not bouncing. I'm not... The skeletons aren't bothering me. I'm not getting wither. This armor is pretty sick. Now, I don't know if I'm not getting wither because of the armor or just because withers actually weren't hitting me and those were only skeletons shooting at me. But, yeah, it just makes that cool sound. And it's funny, that is the sound no matter how why I'm taking damage. It's kind of funny that way. But I'm... Yeah, I'm not getting wither. Oh, that's going to make the Gaia Guardian a whole lot easier if I'm not... Ooh, I haven't seen a compressed blaze yet. Oh, yeah, just watch them just all spread out and try to get me. But you can't. You can't get me because I'm fireproof. And it's a permanent fireproof as long as I have mana. But yeah, getting out of here, that was so funny. When the map glitched out or whatever it did, I'm not exactly sure what it did. Sitting there trying to draw Blaze to follow me over to the portal that I created was really funny. And then having to create the new one and call it Apple, just so as soon as I see it, it's very recognizable and I remember. Yeah, it was a fun time. Fun times. How many did I get? I have 11 so far. I'm going to need a lot more, I have a feeling. I should just probably go over to one of the blaze spawners, because those blaze spawners that I farmed originally are back, which makes me think the nether just reset itself. And but my portal sent me through anyways. I'm really not sure. I couldn't even begin to assume why it did what it did. But I hope you guys spawn fast. You are so annoying. But I love how there's no knockback. There's no punch or whatever, which is really, really nice. And I literally don't even realize I'm taking damage. Like, I'm not even taking damage. I'm losing zero hearts whatsoever. I'm losing a little bit of RF from my armor, and that's about it. This this draconic stuff is pretty sick. But it's expensive, so I mean, it better be worth it. Oh, it's a void one. Don't run across those too often. Where'd you go? There was another one right over here. There he is. Okay, how many we got? We got 19. I needed 16 tanks with 4, so I need a full stack. We need more blaze. Come on, spawn. Spawn. Spawn some blaze. There you go. A vengeance. Is that it? Was it? Yeah, vengeance blaze. Interesting. This is kind of fun. It's fun being in the nether and not worrying about dying. Like, I'm a little bit OP for the nether now, which is cool. And while I've got you guys here, and while we're flying around and just hiding blazes, I do have some questions for, like, do you guys like the pace of the series and, like, how I'm doing it kind of step by step and actually not doing a lot off camera? Because this is the first time I've really done this much off camera, and you'll understand what I mean by this much when, we get to the end of the episode. Or would you rather me kind of do it in chunks and just kind of evolve a little bit more off camera and just kind of show more of the fun stuff on camera? I'm genuinely curious about that because I enjoy kind of the step-by-step stuff. Like, you know, you guys know I'm constantly learning. You listen to me constantly learn. Even though I know a lot of stuff ahead of time, I'm constantly trying to teach myself new stuff that I've never experienced before and whatever. And I like that aspect. But at the same time, like, when it came to this episode, there was just a lot of stuff that I wanted to prep for Draconic. And some of it just seemed too grindy, and so I wanted to do a lot of it off camera. But I could have done stuff in the meantime and kind of, you know, played with other mods and stuff like that while I was doing that grindy stuff. I mean, I got very, like, headstrong about getting this stuff done for the Draconic. Hey. Why are you so strong? Why are you so strong? Why, you just don't want to die. Oh, dude, I am so, like... Oh, my sword's dead. Huh. Well, I guess that does it for our time in the Nether. Where is my base? Waypoints on. Where are you? You are this way. Okay, there it is. Okay, cool. I can turn you off now. Off. Yeah, just I'm really interested in what you guys think in regards to that. You know, constantly showing everything that's going on, or if I should take more time in between episodes to kind of prep and get like a lot of the grindy stuff out of the way, and that way it's just a matter of grabbing the materials I need to make whatever I'm going to make in that episode, and kind of experience that way. Like, let me know down in the comments. For those of you guys follow on Twitter, you can always hit me on Twitter with that stuff too. That way I know, and I can start kind of pacing my episodes a little bit different, because I kind of look and I'm like, you know, I'm on episode, this is episode 23, and I look at a lot of other people's episodes, and when they're at episode 23, they're like so far ahead of where I'm at right now. And so I'm really thinking that maybe they just pace it out a lot more than I do. I guess that's the only way to say it, really. Might as well charge you up a little here. And there we go. I need to move this, like one of these blocks at least to the other side, to the overworld. But, oh, that's something I wanted to show you. Actually, I didn't even think about what I was doing right there. Well, I can go back in a second. Let's go make the rest of these tanks that I can make. And I can make quite a few. Okay, we got 6 tanks, not to mention these two. So we've got 8 tanks. That's enough for 4 for sure if that... bedrockium drum doesn't work the way I wanted it to work. But if it fills automatically, then I don't need any of these tanks, and that whole trip to the Nether was pointless. Do you accept? You do accept! But you have milk in you. How in the world? Y'all are too close! It's milk in you! I don't want to milk you! Get out of here! Oh my goodness. Okay, so I know I gotta keep them more spread out than they are, but at least I know the bedrockium drum. Hey, come on. Come on, man. Come on, man. Freaking a bedrockium drum for milk. Oh, and it's shearing that guy too. That poor guy lost his wool to that. Okay. This is all gonna get prettier later. This is definitely gonna get prettier later. But I want to make sure that they're far enough away. Get away, guys. I didn't know what the range on the rancher is, but apparently it's better than I thought it was. The reason I have that guy so close is because I didn't think it was that good. All right, let's dump some of this stuff. Wrath shards. I got to find out about those. Ooh, got a couple wither skulls. That's always cool. Ender tank. I forget which ones. Oh, that's the bedrockium ones. Okay, cool. And... yeah, fence can go there. That'll be power. I think I got it all straight. Okay, I don't need the compactors right now. Oh, Reaper 5. Yeah, yeah. I totally forgot about this. So when I first started, I was explaining this whole Reaper thing. I want to get a Reaper 5. Actually, we'll do that in a little while. We will go back to that. I won't forget. I promise. I'm keeping this book right here so I don't forget to do that. But I did want an axe because this is going to bother me if this thing's up here like this. Okay. So apparently, I need to grab some buckets. I've already got a couple buckets of milk. Because I was testing earlier and there was milk in this as I put one of my tanks down. So, buckets of milk. There we go. Now you're filled with bedrockium. Okay, that's awesome. That is awesome because that means I don't even need any of these ender tanks that I just did. I can put like an ender tank on one of them and transfer stuff elsewhere. And I do have 8 ender tanks. Oh, no. What am I doing? I forgot. That is how I keep you trapped in there. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and shrink this cage down a little bit so it doesn't look quite as bad. We're just going to trap these guys in these tiny little areas. And it's going to be so sad, but so effective. I do feel bad, dude. It's like, it's almost like the, you know, the, I don't want to say the humanitarian in me, because that's not quite the right word, but okay, so we're going to skip a block and go over here. Right? And it's just going to be like, oh no, don't need to do that. That's where the rancher's going to go. So we're just going to trap them in there like that. And this is going to start our farms. And this will be awesome. And we will be rocking it. Just like that. And yeah, and then I got a lasso. I got this lasso here. I like to, like I said, I've never actually used a lasso. I always use safari nets, so I was trying something new and different. Enderium, or Resident Ender, not Enderium, Resident Ender. There we go. So you're going to get milked there. Kind of glitching there, homie. Let me grab my shovel here. Like that. And we're going to connect you. Oh, I already have a straight line. Ha! I already have a straight line. The rancher's just up one. Okay. So if I, as long as I go down this line, I'm good to go. That's kind of funny. Oh. Oh, these are all fake blocks right here. Oh, no, they're not. They're just acting really goofy. Okay. I'm going to get this figured out. There we go. And I didn't need much energy conduit at all because it's all already there. So now you got energy, right? And you've got Resident Ender in you. Sweet! Okay. So let's get all these, as many of these set up as we can, at least. God, that's really loud. Okay. And let me put this dirt block back in there. And then we'll put a tank behind you. And then over here, we need a fence again. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on top, over and over. All right. And the next one is going to go right here. So I don't need the tanks right now. There we go. Conduit right there. And it does some really glitchy things visually. But it's okay. It's got power. And now we'll go grab another useful cow like... Well, what's the most used? Invar? I don't know. Molten glass is kind of curious to me. All right, so you do that. Yeah, you're kind of glitching out. All right. And I need to get some more fence. How much fence do I have? I don't have a lot, do I? I have 22. Not a lot, but enough to do what we're doing right now. Here, I'll just move you out of the way. There we go. And let's set up another one. Right there. All right, so we're gonna have our Move Fluids farm going really, really soon, which will be awesome. This is something I've been looking into doing or thinking about doing. I just hadn't actually got around to it. And it's such a simple concept. I don't know why I didn't. Invar, where's the Invar guy? There's the Invar guy. There we go. They're so lonely. They just look so lonely. It's almost sad for me. Like, they just look so sad. Why are you idle? Go ahead and work. Okay, there we go. And you've tapped into him. I wish there was a way I could just put a filter. Oh. Oh. Oh, my sludge boiler's getting me. Totally forgot you were down here. Well, I don't want to put any cows close to that. Totally forgot you were down there. I'm going to have to move this sludge boiler somewhere else away. I might just put it out like on a floating island somewhere. I mean, it's cool. It gets me stuff, but yeah. Let's see. We can do a fence here. 1, 2, 3. Right there and right there. There we go. And I can just chop out these two pieces. And as a matter of fact, I'm going to have to close this off right here. Hey, move. There we go. All right, and that gives me a little bit more. Ah, didn't want to break that one. I wanted that one. All right, so that is... Well, I can just leave that, huh? Yep. I can just leave that, because that way... You, and you. There we go. And that's going to be the last one on this side. And you, and you. And in case you guys don't know, I'm putting these things over because the cows will jump up on top of the ranchers. That's all I'm doing here, is preventing the cows from trying to get out of the pens. How did I mess that up? How did I hit the wrong spot? I'm done with the axe, so. Okay, put you there. And you. And you. Alright. Now I just gotta go across from here. And connect all these guys up. I think that's it. I think that was the last one, right? Yes, it is. Okay. Now, get some conduit out. And then we'll go make some bedrockium drums. And call this one kind of accomplished. Yeah, kind of stuck here. Kind of stuck. Okay, there we go. And get that fence back. There we are. All right. Rancher there. And there. And we are looking good. We are looking real good. This is actually a really useful farm over here. What do we got here? What's this pink guy? Manilium? Yeah, I've already been milking you for a while. So you're used to it. And I think Electrum. Electrum I probably use probably the next most of. Like so. So I'm going to need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 more bedrockium drums. That's easy. That's really, really easy. I hate the rain, so let's go to sleep real quick and avoid the rain. And then once we get these bedrockium drums set up, I will take you on a tour of the stuff that I've done in the meantime, and everything else I was talking about earlier will make more sense. And hopefully, by the time we get to the next episode, I will be ready to respawn the Ender Dragon. What did I do with that tank? I need my bedrockium back. Totally forgot about you. Need you and an item duct. Okay, all this nonsense can just go. I'll deal with you later. And deal with you later. And deal with you later. And there you go. Okay, I need a fluid duct. And a servo. Actually, I don't even think I need the servo. Actually, I know I don't need the servo. I'm going to be so determined about this. I know I don't need it. Because the cool thing about these tanks, as you can see, it's full. I just turn the knob and it pushes it out into the system. Does it automatically. And there we go. We're going to make a couple bedrockium blocks here. Then go make the barrels and we will be good to go. They're actually pretty cheap to make. I mean, minus the bedrocking, which is really expensive, but the moo fluid cows or whatever, they obviously made this much, much easier. And I think it's so funny that I'm so slow with bedrockium, but I can still sprint my way right out of slowness. Yeah, you can't affect me. Okay, and that should be enough. 9. Still got 3 left. Yeah, that'll be enough. I need 6 per. So I need 30 total ingots, and this will give me 27 plus the 3 remaining. Perfect. I like when the numbers work out perfect. Okay, cool. So let's run over here and get these barrels down. So I need gold plates. Right. I need you. I'm going to need 2 per, so I'm going to need 10. Hopefully I have enough gold. Yes, I do. Okay. And then I need to make some vats. Oh, no, sorry. Cauldrons. Oh, and I happen to have 8, so we're good there. And bedrockium. Go ahead and just break that down. And put that in there. There we go. And now I just need to make the drum. Like a soul. There we go. There's the 5. Sweet! And it's funny how the bedrockium drum is made of 6 bedrockium ingots, but that doesn't slow me down. Now, why would that slow me down? Alright. So you get yours, you get yours, you get yours, you get yours, and you get yours. And I love how they color code. So that's molten and electrum in there, that is manilium, that is bedrockium, that is ender, resident ender, molten glass, and invar. And then I can literally just put these empty tanks on them if I wanted to. Well, I put them away. But I can do this Bedrockium drum. And I can put you on that and turn you to insert like this. And I believe... Which way does it go? Nope. This one I might actually need a fluid duct for. That I might actually need a fluid duct for. Unless I put you like that, will you take in from there? Nope. So I'll figure that out. I'll figure out a way. But I mean, at this point, I'm never going to need any of these substances ever again because I can hold so many buckets in these things. And I mean, I'm already up to 2 buckets each, and it's just going to keep going. So let me kind of show you what's gone on since the last episode, and we'll wrap this one up. Usually I do this before, but I was just excited as I was doing this. I'll go back to finish up over here. I just found out that I could put this on top of that. That was probably like the coolest, most exciting thing that I had found so far today. So anyways, as you can see, there is liquid XP going into that. And I will show you why, because I have created a new mob farm. I have actually turned off that mob farm in the Batania area. And I got this guy down here. And apparently they are growing on a slime chunks. Hey, don't break the torch. That's just annoying when you do that. All right. I think it's really funny that they're on a slime chunk. Let's see, that torch goes right here in the middle. And so you can hear it kind of going crazy. I am really like right down at zero. Like we are on the I'm actually below. I'm at -2 right here. So I'm going to turn this off real quick just so you can kind of see. So basically, oh, there's a whole bunch of XP that's not being... I mean, there's that much XP in the system. It fills this thing up so fast, it cannot transfer it fast enough into the tank. So coming down here every now and then becomes valuable just to get all that extra XP. And I eventually want to enchant these iron spikes with this Reaper enchantment that I was telling you about at the very beginning, this guy right here. But I'm going to keep working at getting it. So basically the XP goes in here, and then this chest is sucking everything up and putting it in my inventory system. I'm going to have to figure out a filter for that because let's just say it's getting too much stuff. But look how many guys just right on those spikes and just dumping stuff, tons of stuff. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So that was one of the major things I've done, and I'm going to redo this thing, but I think I'm going to do it in the end because I want to start getting going on RF tools and create a dimension. And to do that, I'm going to need some blank dimlets, and they're more commonly dropped by the Enderman, or maybe only dropped by the Enderman, I don't know. I haven't quite figured that out yet. But anyways, going back to this, so I've got tons of XP just flowing in here. And then I found out if I just throw the tank on top of the obelisk, it basically just does the work for me. I didn't realize that I could do this. And I had been doing this for almost 2 days, like this, and literally taking this little guy, this experience rod, and going like this to the tank, and then basically putting it, you know, doing the enchantments and stuff like that. Now that I know that every time this gets experience, it's just going to drop it right in, and you can see it's just slowly pouring in, and then right click, there we go, and it's just dumping levels in. But now I can do 2 more enchantments. So this is the next thing I wanted to show you guys. This is why the Wavern or whatever it's called is so cool to me. First of all, you don't need books anymore. I spent my first day trying to do this with books, and then I found out that I didn't even need the books, and I was kind of sad about that. Sad because I, you know, tried so hard to get all this done and then realized I was wasting my time. So there's a config, like you can config all this stuff or whatever. There's a config, and you just go to the sword and go to the inventory, and all the enchantments that are on it are right just here in books. It just creates the books for you. And so I just take them all off. And now I've just got all these enchantment books. I've got Sharpness 4, Reaper 4, Soulbound 1, Knockback 2, and then the Reaper 4. And what I want that for right now is this. Reaper 4. And Reaper 4 gives me Reaper 5, which is BA. And now I can just go ahead and throw you three into there. And if you thought I was kidding, I've done a lot of enchanting. That's all the books, and that's like leveled up the books. These knockback two, I'm not going to see a big need for. So you can see I've got like nine of them because I stopped doubling them up and increasing them. But now I've got Reaper 5, and that is probably how we're going to finish up the episode, is trying to go get some of these souls for the next episode, because I really, really have plans. I do. I have plans. They don't always work out, but I have plans. And put you away. Hammer goes there. This is my tank for something. Oh, that was my Bedrockium tank. Where'd my other Bedrockium tank go? Did I leave it sitting over there? See, those are all XP because those are all white right now. It's interesting. I don't know. I don't remember changing color or anything, so. So, yeah. This is putting out a whole bunch of essence. Is it the other way? Ah, it's the other way. Yeah, dump that essence in there. Yeah, so just tons of XP. And I'm just going to put all those back. See, I got 60 levels, so I can enchant again. But we're going to go... Well, before we finish up this, I want to show you the one thing that I've been working on. The reason I have failed to make an episode, because I tried multiple times. And I started getting frustrated that it wasn't working. And I just didn't want to put out a bad episode. And I don't know if that's necessarily a good one, but I did not want to put out a bad episode. And I was, you know, having issues. So I ran over here earlier and did this. I've upgraded my... my vibrator capacitor here. So now it's actually five of them. So it holds up to 125 million RF at a time. And it outputs at 125 per tick. That's freaking awesome. And keep you charged up. Now, over here, this is my creme de la creme of this episode. And oh my God, I tried so many times to record this, but it didn't happen. This is my automated wither killing machine. Okay. I did it decorative so you could see what was going on inside, and I think it's super special. I'm going to show you how it works, or I'm going to show you it work, and then I'll explain it to you. As you can see, I now have 67 wither stars. This system is just, it works. We're going to start it. You're going to see the wither appear. He's going to get shot over to here, and then after he does his kaboomy thing, he is going to die instantly. No, split second, nothing. He's gone. And then this hopper catches everything. There goes the nether star. And then the essence goes into the tank. And the tank is now going into the obelisk. And everything is working freaking great. The reason I didn't want to show this on film or on camera, because I've tried multiple setups and none of them were working. They all seemed logical until I tried them. I finally found one that worked, but I wasn't recording during it. And so I used to use Factory Manager. Not going to get into it because this episode's already getting longer than I had intended, but Steve's Factory Manager will be coming back for auto-crafting purposes. I found out about that, and that's awesome. And yeah, this block right here, this was the demise of me right here. I couldn't get it to work because the Factory Manager has to touch the blocks that it's filling, which is fun. I could have put a block here, but it also needs power to run, and I couldn't get power to it. So all the other blocks, the four block placers, or the three block placers right there, and the three autonomous activators, they're all getting their materials from this chest placed in there from the Factory Manager inventory, or the Machine Inventory Manager. And then this one, it just takes the last soul sand that gets requested and puts it right in that way. Well, that was weird. Tesseract gives it power. Tesseract is also giving power to this guy over here, which is the mob grinder from Draconic Evolution. And there's something I had to do that I want to do on camera as well to get it, which is the ritual to get awakened draconic ingots. But like I said, I did all this stuff multiple times, and the mob grinder was one of the first things I did. I wish I would have saved the footage, but I was so frustrated I got rid of it. But anyways, and then this fan right here is just powered by a switch under. This fan is pushing all the items that the wither drops, and it's just pushing them towards the vacuum hopper to make sure it all goes out along with all the essence, because this is actually only one chamber deep. The glass kind of makes it look like it's two, but it's only one chamber deep. So he dies, and then it just pushes all the stuff to the vacuum hopper. That's that. Now, with you guys watching me, because I've tried this multiple times, but I haven't done it with Reaper 5, I've been trying to get Mob Souls. I've gotten one so far. Just one. Let me put the nether stars away. 68 of them now, guys. 68 nether stars. That's awesome. That's just nuts. Minimal effort. Let me get out some wheat. Ooh, I only have 5. Let me go get some wheat. And we are going to go ahead and go to town on these cows and sheep. And hopefully, we're going to earn ourselves a couple mob souls. I need 4 total. If not, I mean, I'm going to do them off camera anyways. I will get the 4 mob souls because next episode, we will be resurrecting the Ender Dragon. We're bringing him back for fight number 2. And as I say that, I might want to start getting ready for the Gaia Guardian number 2. I don't know how close I am to that point, but I figure if we get the really sick draconic armor and the draconic weapons, then that might be a very viable thing. Because not only do I want the dragon, but I also want the chaos dragon. And that's inevitably what I'm trying to get to. So let's go try to repopulate this group over here. Yeah, you go find yourself a match. There you go. You and you. You and you. And then you can go find that guy who I already got. You and you. And dude, I'm sorry, but you're the lone cow out. Now, we have our Reaper 5 on here. We're going to get a mob soul. We're going to get one. I've got a cow head, but not a mob soul. You. How many is that? I'm down to 2 regular cows, but do I have 2 babies? I have at least 2 babies. Okay, cool. You and you. How many baby sheep I have? I got 2 baby sheep. Cool. So I'm going to finish killing all these guys, and then I'm going to check, and I hope we get a soul. 3 babies. Did we get any souls? I got no souls. So far, the very first time I swiped with this thing, it's so funny, I got the mob soul of this slime here. And it was kind of funny. It was the very first shot. I've killed so many animals since then and have not gotten one soul since then. So I don't know what to do to improve upon my chances. Reaper is supposed to increase the chance. Yeah, it's supposed to increase. I think, hold on. I read the description here. No description was found for this enchantment. Yeah, it's supposed to increase the chance of getting the mob souls. So eventually I want to get a couple more. So I'm going to keep enchanting this thing. So then I can enchant the diamond blocks with Reaper. And then hopefully I will collect mob souls that way. That'd be awesome if that's the case. But guys, I hope you enjoyed. I hope you like the direction that this series is taking. If you've got any questions, comments, concerns, let me know. Because you know I'm more than open to taking suggestions. I try to write back to you guys whenever you guys message me. And, you know, keep in contact with you guys. Because this content is for you. As well as me having fun, it's for you guys to enjoy watching and coming up with ideas of stuff to try and whatnot. So let me know what you guys think. And I will continue to try to put out quality stuff for you guys. But until next time, guys, you know the deal. I'm Slider, and I'm out of here. Peace. Had to come back for one more second because this is just too funny. I literally just got off. Like, you can look at the timestamp. It's, 2:57, whatever. I literally just got off. Came back, was like, oh, hey, let's try enchanting those last 2 enchantments. Very first one I get, another Reaper 4. I swear to you, I spent almost 2 days, real days, not Minecraft days, 2 days trying to get one Reaper 4. And then I got one at the start of the episode and one at the end of the episode. So maybe, you know what? I need to stop putting off and just get episodes out for you guys instead of doing the grindy stuff. Maybe that's what it's telling me. Get on camera. It's going to happen. The cool stuff will happen. So anyways, guys, just wanted to get you caught up on that one. Peace.